Welcome to Hard Talk. I'm Isaiah. You're here for the hard truth, and I'm here to give it to you. People with high levels of self-doubt are easy to manipulate. These people will hold on to anything other people tell them because they're never sure what to believe. They don't know what to believe because they don't believe in themselves. So instead, they follow others. They get super interested in other people's hobbies and daily lives, changing their goals and pursuits constantly. And when challenged, these same people question everything. They fear the worst and imagine each and every possible worst-case scenario. As a result, they never do anything significant. Instead, they float through life without having any direction, rotating between feeling stuck and frustrated on the one hand and lost and hopeless on the other hand. When I was in the third grade, we used to have show and tell every week. I remember one week, a girl brought in a small blue egg that was left in a nest at her house. I was so excited to see it. The girl who brought the egg must have seen my eyes light up because she said, "Don't give the egg to Isaiah, he'll break it." "What? I won't break the egg." That's what I shouted. But then as the nest with the egg in it started being passed around, I started thinking, wait, what if I do break the egg? How embarrassing would it be if I broke the egg? I think I might accidentally break the egg. Oh no, I'm definitely going to break the egg. This is exactly what went through my head. Then, when the nest came to me with the little blue egg in it, I picked up the egg carefully and it cracked between my fingers. What happened? I mentally prophesized my future. I let someone infect me with their doubt, and as a result, I started doubting myself. Look, doubt is infectious. Studies show that doubt can be passed from one person to another, similar to how diseases like the flu or the common cold are passed between people. These studies also show that people with high levels of self-doubt have less confidence and are slower to achieve their goals. So self-doubt is never a good thing. If you want to accomplish big things in your life, you have to keep doubt from infecting you. In particular, you need to do these three things. First, avoid people who second-guess everything you do. It's impossible to believe in yourself 100% when you're surrounded by people who don't believe in you. On a long enough timeline, your confidence will give in and the constant bombardment of self-doubt will win. It's biological. Your brain is wired to copy the thoughts, feelings, and behaviors of other people. So the only way to win the battle for your own self-belief is to actively decide who you let into your life. If you want to increase your levels of confidence and achieve your goals quickly, you must eliminate people who second-guess everything you do. Second-guessers are those people who always predict all the bad things that will happen to you if you take on a new challenge. They're the people who never offer solutions and only highlight problems. They just predict failure, doom, and gloom. So stop listening to these people. Their predictions are based on nothing but fear. Second, raise the stakes on what you're doing. You can't overcome self-doubt by fighting it with more self-doubt. Too many people make the mistake of combating their temporary feelings of doubt by lowering the bar for themselves. You know these types. They're the ones who say, "Oh, I'm not that good," or "I'll probably mess up," right before performing a task. The problem is that trying to take pressure off of yourself by pretending to be more of a failure than you are will actually make you more of a failure. You'll have to set the bar lower and lower each time until what you do doesn't matter at all. A better strategy is to raise the bar, higher your standards, and add pressure to yourself and your goals. Make what you do unbelievably important and take yourself seriously. This way, if you fail, you won't be filled with more self-doubt because you were striving for something great. And if you succeed, you'll be forced to internalize your success because you made it a big part of your life. Third, take action as your best self, not your worst self. Too many people lose confidence in themselves simply because they wait too long to take action. They get their nerve up to do something big, then they hesitate. This initial moment of hesitation plants a seed of doubt that grows with each passing moment. Eventually, their doubt has grown into a giant oak tree, a wall that they can't see past. Most often, people who hesitate know what they want and who they want to be, but they never move towards it. Instead of visualizing what their best self would do and just doing it, they imagine what their worst self would do and hesitate out of fear. A better strategy is to take action and learn as you go. Don't imagine what your worst self would do. Imagine what your best self would do, what your bold self would do, and then jump in and do it. Any mistakes you make by taking bold action can easily be corrected by taking more bold action. Do this and you will live a more confident and focused life. Until next time, live like a lion.